Hello friends, I am Rajgopal. I am teaching Saibala. Let us continue with the topics. In the last 4 to 5 classes, we have discussed the introduction of Saibala, how the Saibala has come into existence, what is the purpose of Saibala, importance of Saibala and IT Act 2000, different provisions, important provisions of IT Act 2000 and the Amendment Act 2008. All these things we have discussed. Let us continue with the IT Act 2000. Before continuing, let us see what we have discussed in the last class. So, we have discussed in the previous class, we have discussed the regulation of certifying authorities, appointment of controller and other officers. Okay, certifying authority is one which will issue the digital certificates, and for that the controller will be appointed by the central government to certify the certifying authorities, to give the legal permission to the certifying authorities to issue the digital signature certificates. So now in the today's agenda, let us have a discussion about the digital signature certificates. In that, mainly how the digital signature certificates will be issued, what are all the eligibility criteria, how to apply, what is the prescribed fee that you have to pay at the time of getting the digital signature certificates, and to which authority you have to approach to get the digital signature certificate, how, in what factors or in what circumstances the digital signature certificates will be suspended or taken away, and how it will be revoked if it is taken back, or if we have surrendered, how it can be revoked, how we can get it back. That will be discussed in the last part of this, and the notice of the suspension, how to issue, under what provision of Income Tax IT Act, Information Technology Act 2000, under which provision we have to give the notice. All these things let us discuss in the first session, and in the second, duties of the subscriber and generating of the key pair. And what is the acceptance, what do you mean by acceptance of digital signature certificates, and what do you mean by the control of private key. Moreover, for all these things, which are all the provisions which will be in support of all these points, is an important thing that we are going to discuss here, my dear friends. In the previous classes, the subject experts have explained how to prepare, how to create a digital certificate. Okay, what do you mean by a digital signature? What do you mean by private key? And all these things you have come to know in the previous chapters. Now, it is the provision of law which will give a legal framework for all these points. That is the important point that we are going to discuss in the today's agenda. Okay, let us go to the next slide. So, digital signature certificates. Here, my dear friends, the digital signature certificate is the one issued by a certifying authority necessary for undertaking to sign digitally. Here, I want to clarify. There may be, here we are discussing an electronic signature. What do you mean by a physical signature and an e-signature? What is the difference between the physical signature and an electronic signature or a digital signature, whatever it may be? A physical signature certificate means to give the identity, your identity, to a required authority, to the authority which will question your identity. wherever it is required, you have to produce. For example, one example that I can give you is while entering an airport. With your, there will be a valid ticket will be there. With this, you have to show your identity. It can be a passport where you have signed physically. That is a physical signature certificate, we can tell. That is your identity. Or it may be your Aadhaar card, or it may be your PAN card, or it may be your voter ID card. Something you will show and you will get entrance into the particular area. So here the digital signature certificate or digital signature means it is an electronic, it will be in an electronic form. How it will be authorized, where you will sign, that is the important question, where you will make use of it. What is the legal provision which will give a legal approval to the digital signature? That is under section 35 of Information Technology Act. A digital signature certificate will be validated, and once you get the digital signature certificate, you are authorized to sign in a place where the digital signature certificate will be approved. Okay, that is the broader meaning of digital signature certificate, my dear friends. So now let us discuss about who will issue the digital signature certificates. As we have discussed in the last class, certifying authority or CA will issue the digital signature certificate. So to approach the CA for the issue of DSC, the fees will be not exceeding 25,000 you have to pay for getting the digital signature certificate, to be accompanied with a certificate of practice. After receipt of application, the CA may consider, okay, after considering all the facts, may grant or reject the same by giving some proper reasons. Okay, that is the certifying authority will issue the digital signature certificate. You have to pay the prescribed fees, which will not be exceeding 25,000, and you have to give, along with that, you have to give the certificate of practice and other certificates which are mentioned, as mentioned by the central government. And then after that, you have to submit that. After within 6 to 7 working days, you will get, everything is proper means, you will get your digital signature certificate, okay, which is the certificate which contains the authorization for a person to sign digitally. Okay, or otherwise it may contain private key and public key. How to use all these things will be there in a digital signature certificate. Okay, here it is clearly mentioned that after going through the facts, it may grant the digital signature certificate, or by giving the proper reasons, the same can be rejected. Okay, so here section 36 of Information Technology Act will give the representation upon the issuance of digital signature certificates. Okay, if it is complied with the provisions of the Act, published the DSC and made available to the subscriber, it can be made available to the subscriber. Subscriber, as I have told, they will hold private and public key. Both the keys from will form the functional key pair, and the information in digital signature certificate will be an accurate. Okay, the section 36 of Information Technology Act will give the, according to the provisions of Act, it will authorize a person to sign digitally in the place wherever it is required. Either it may be a bank employee, or it may be an income tax, or whatever may be. Once if he is authorized to sign digitally, he can make use of the digital signature certificate till the time of expiry. That is very much important here. The digital signature certificate, it is not a permanent one, as we have discussed in the last sections. A time will be given. Up to that, you can use the digital signature certificate. Once after the expiry, you have to make a fresh application for the renewal. Okay. So the next is the section 37, suspension of digital signature certificates. Under what circumstances the digital signature certificates can be suspended? There are two things. Either we can apply, a holder of digital signature certificate can apply or ask the certifying authority that it has to be suspended, or otherwise with the public interest it can be suspended. If it is suspended by the certifying authority, a proper reasoning has to be given and it has to be intimated through the notice. Okay, let us see with respect to the provisions of the law. Okay, so section 37 of Information Technology Act will tell how the digital signature certificate should be suspended. Okay, the CA can suspend the DSC, digital signature certificate, on the request of a subscriber. Subscriber can request directly, or an authorized person of the subscriber can give a requisition for the suspension of digital signature certificate. There may be a number of reasons. Means it may not be necessary after that to sign digitally, then he can apply for the suspension of digital signature certificate, or otherwise if he is using some other options for sign digitally, he can go for the cancellation of digital signature certificates. So there are so many options. There will be a provision under IT Act, so the subscriber can ask for the suspension of his digital signature certificates. Okay, immediately the action will be taken and it will be suspended if the proper reasoning is given. Okay, and if it is the opinion of the public interest, if somebody feels he is misusing the digital signature certificate, is misused, then the certifying authority can take an action and it can be suspended on the public interest. Should not suspend for 15 days, and if suspended, the same must be communicated. Okay, 15 days means a notice should be served. If it is the action of the controlling authority, if it is an action of certifying authority, a notice has to be given why they want to suspend this particular digital signature certificate, and they have to wait for the reply. If the reply is not given, then the action can be taken, or otherwise if it has to be suspended immediately, then the communication should reach a particular person why this suspension is taking place. So there is a clear provision in the law how the digital signature certificate should be suspended. Okay, either it may be on the request of the subscriber, or the authorized person of the subscriber, or it can be a public interest, or it can be due to some other reasons where it has to be suspended. Okay, next. Similarly, the revocation of the suspension. Under what circumstances the digital signature certificate can be revoked? So here the same, once the subscriber, if he applies for the suspension of the digital signature certificate, he can specify the term. Up to certain period it can be suspended, it can be kept on a hold. On the request, again, CA may revoke the DSC. Again, for the revoking of digital signature certificate, the eligible authority is the certifying authority. So, certifying authority only has to revoke the digital signature certificates. It may be on the request of an authorized person, of the subscriber or the subscriber directly. If he requests to revoke the digital signature certificate, for that he has a particular format will be there. He has to give an application for the revocation of his digital signature certificate. Then it will be considered based on certain requirements and criteria. Okay, that is already specified in the by the certifying authority. Okay, that a signature can be revoked, and upon the death of the subscriber also it can be revoked, and upon the dissolution of the firm it can be revoked. Okay, the digital signature certificate can be revoked. Here the revocation of digital signature certificate means suspension, means the temporarily it will be blocked for a certain period. Revocation means some action that has to be taken on the digital signature certificate. It can be the application of the subscriber or an authorized person. If the holder of the digital signature certificate, if there is a death, or the firm having the digital signature certificate has been dissolved, then also it can be revoked. It can be on the second issue, the material fact in the DSC, if it is false, then also it can be revoked. The requirement, if it is not satisfied, then, and the subscriber is insolvent or dead, then also it can be revoked. The section 38 of IT Act will clearly mention on what circumstances the digital signature certificates can be revoked. So, DSC, continuation of the previous slide, a DSC shall not be revoked unless an opportunity to be given to the subscriber. Again, the same thing, either it may be in the case of certifying authority's license or the digital signature certificate or whatever may be, a proper chance has to be given, a fair chance has to be given for the holder of digital signature certificate or the subscriber or the authorized person of the subscriber to present his case properly. Okay, then only it has to be revoked or suspended or whatever may be. On revocation of CA, on revocation, the CA shall communicate the same to the subscriber. If it is revoked on any other grounds, okay, the same has to be communicated to the subscriber. That is more important under the provision in the section 38 of Information Technology Act. Okay, so here the notice of suspension, section 39 will give the legal provision for giving the notice of suspension. Here in the section 39 it is clearly mentioned that a person has to be issued a notice before the suspension. Okay, if the DSE has to be suspended on various reasons, okay, on the various reasons, if the certifying authority feels that particular digital signature certificate has to be suspended, unless otherwise it is an application from the subscriber or an authorized person of the subscriber on any other grounds, then the certifying authority shall publish the same on the repository. Repository, as we have discussed, it is a place where all the digital signature certificates are stored. It is a place. Okay, there a notice has to be published so that it should reach the holder of the DSC or the subscriber. So for what reason that particular DSC is going to be suspended? And here any law will tell an equal opportunity has to be given to every client or every citizen to represent the same before the authority or to question the same before the authority. So here a notice has to be served to a subscriber or to an authorized person of the subscriber or to the firm so before suspending the digital signature certificate. If there is one or more repositories, CA should publish the same in all the repositories. If it is digital signature certificate is there in one or more repositories, then the notice has to be published in all the repositories. Similarly, repositories, it is a place where digital signature certificates are stored, or whatever may be, a database where it is maintained. So if it is comes to the physical address, if there are one or more address of the company, a notice has to be served to all the places, and a proper time has to be given. After that only, if there is no reply, then they can go for a suspension. After verifying that it has reached that particular person and particular person has gone through the notice, then only if he has represented, if he has approached, then a proper action will be taken, otherwise it can be suspended. So under section 39 of Information Technology Act, there is a clear provision how the notice has to be given, to which are all the places the notice has to be served, okay, what action they have to take after giving the notice. All these things are mentioned in the section 39 of Information Technology Act. Okay, then next coming to the section 40 of Information Technology Act, where there is a clear mention of duties of the subscriber. Subscriber is the one with respect to this particular Information Technology Act, with respect to the digital signature, is the one who is having the digital signature certificate. His only one duty of the subscriber is he has to hold the key pair by applying the security procedures. Okay, the key pair means private key and public key will be there in his system, and he has to give an access to an authorized person, or he himself, subscriber himself, has to operate that. He should have a proper security procedure to get that particular key pair. Okay, if it is misused, okay, there are some provisions that we will take in the next few slides. If there is a misuse of that particular key, then it has to be immediately informed to the certifying authority that there is an interference in the key pair. Okay, if somebody has interfered, if somebody has unauthorizedly accessed the key pair, then it has to be immediately intimated, and then a proper action can be taken with respect to that. Here one best example that I can give is a credit card or a debit card. If you are having a credit card or a debit card, means that is equivalent to a digital signature certificate. Okay, that is like a digital signature certificate. You are authorized, or an authorized person, you can authorize somebody to use that particular credit card or a debit card. Okay, once if somebody misuses, for example, if you lost that credit card or a debit card, then what action? It will be clearly written on that certificate itself. Immediately you have to inform the bank authority. A number will be given, you have to inform that, so that they can block. The misuse can be stopped. Okay, the misuse of that particular credit card or debit card will be stopped. The access to that particular debit card or the credit card will be electronically stopped. That will become not usable, and then you can apply for the fresh one, and they can then you can get the fresh credit card or debit card. That is the equivalent of the same, my dear friends. Okay, if you are having the digital signature certificate, the main thing is you have to secure, you have to see that the subscriber is using that, or an authorized person is using that particular digital signature certificate, if we get an information somebody is misusing, then it has to be immediately informed to a particular certifying authority so that they will take a proper action in blocking that digital signature, private key and public key, and after that they will reissue the fresh one so that you can go afresh with the digital signature certificate. Okay, so this is the best example, my dear friends. Next, let us go to the section 41 of digital signature certificate. So the acceptance of digital signature certificate, when it will be treated as that you have been or the subscriber has accepted the digital signature certificate, on what circumstances it will be assumed that the subscriber started using the digital signature certificate. Once if you get the credit card, my dear friends, one best example, once if you get the credit card by post or if you collect it through the bank, bank is the certifying authority. Okay, if you collect it or if you get it through the post, immediately you can't use, you have to collect the PIN. Okay, that is your private key, whatever we can call, that is your private key, you have to receive the PIN. Or there may be some procedure specified by the certifying authority to enable your certificate, your credit card or whatever may be, to enable that. There may be some procedures that you have to follow, go to the nearest ATM center, insert that card, insert the security key that is provided. It may ask some personal information that you have to enter, then you will get a key, that is your private key, you will get, that is your PIN number. Once after using the PIN number, if you start using that credit card, if you start transacting using that credit card, then it will be deemed to assume that you are using that particular credit card or debit card. From that date, it is treated as you are using that credit card or debit card or whatever may be. Okay, if you are not followed that procedure, if you are simply keeping that particular credit card, means that will be treated as till now you are not using that particular credit card. Okay, here the same thing. If you are using the DSC, means you are entering the private and public key, you are enabling that and you have given the information within the subscriber. Okay, so let us see the provision of the act. Okay, the subscriber shall be deemed to have accepted the digital signature certificate if he publishes or authorizes the publications. Okay, if he authorizes the publication, then it is deemed that it is assumed that a subscriber is using the digital signature certificate. Okay, once if he has enabled, okay, through the procedures that is mentioned by the certifying authority, then it is assumed that he is using that particular digital signature certificate. By accepting the DSC, the subscriber certifies that entitled to have private and public key. Okay, all the information in DSC are true. All the information are within the knowledge of the subscriber. Once he enables the digital signature certificate, he is entitled to have private and public key. That is there with him, it is assumed. If he authorizes some person or if somebody misuses or whatever may happen, for that the subscriber is held responsible if he will not inform the certifying authority in a proper time. And he is entitled to have private and public key. That is his right to have his private and public key. He can use wherever it is required. And all the information and DSC are true. It will mean that if he starts using means, all the information that he has accepted, okay, For example, if you have taken a credit card means, if there is a spelling mistake in your name or date of birth or whatever may be, you have to inform the particular authority and you have to get a fresh. I'm giving an example, my dear friends. If you start using means, that is, you have accepted whatever it is there in the digital signature certificate, whatever is there in the credit card or debit card. You have accepted that all the information in the mentioned in the digital signature certificate are true, and all the information are within the knowledge of the subscriber. Whatever the action that is taking place with respect to digital signature certificate is with the knowledge of the subscriber only. If you are using the credit card means, that it will be treated as the subscriber is using, or an authorized person of the subscriber is using the credit card. It will not be assumed that somebody other than the subscriber or the authorized person of the subscriber is using, unless you have given a complaint against that misuse. Okay, the clearly in section 41 it is there, it is mentioned that if you start using, if you obtain the private and public key, if you start using, if you have given that, if you have authorized that, then it is assumed that you have accepted all the terms and conditions and you are going, you are following all the security measures that is mentioned in the digital signature certificate under section 41 of Information Technology Act. Okay, section 42. Here the control of private key. Control of private key means the subscriber shall exercise the reasonable care to retain the control of the private key corresponding to the public key. So the private key and the public key are under the control of subscriber only. Okay, private key will be there with the subscriber and the public key will be given to some other person who is authorized to get that letter or whatever may be, e-data, electronic data, who is authorized to get it, who is authorized to have that facility. Okay, that is private key and public key. So here the control of private key means the subscriber shall exercise the reasonable care to retain the control of private key corresponding to the public key. Okay, he should have, the subscriber should have the control over the private key. For example, in the credit card, you should have the control over the PIN number. Okay, if it is a banking transaction or whatever may be, the PIN code, PIN number or the password that you are going to give, that you should have in your control. Okay, with respect to that public key, that banking people will be using that. With respect to the digital signature certificate, the private key you will be having, the public key will be there. Unless otherwise you have a control over the private key, then the public key will be the safe. Okay, if somebody misuses that, then there will be a problem. So the control of private key under section 42, private key should be under the control of subscriber, so that to the corresponding public key. For your account number in the bank, you will be having the private key. So if somebody misuses by knowing your private key means, then you will be under trouble. Okay, that is the clear mention of section 42 of the Information Technology Act. One best example, one case study I can give you here, my dear friends. One client has come to me personally and he told, from my account so much amount, nearing to some 40,000, has been drawn by some other person without my consent. I asked how it is possible. I asked him to explain the things what happened step by step. He told somebody called and they wanted to issue a fresh card, okay, with more facilities they wanted to issue, and they have asked all the details of the existing card which is there with me. I have told card number, CVV number, everything I have told. They told me that they will send an OTP that you have to give to us. Okay, he has received an OTP and he has disclosed that OTP, one-time password, to the person who called. Okay, then immediately after that, an amount has been deducted from his account. So there is a clear misuse of the account. A provision, he should not have given the private key. It should be under the control of that particular subscriber only. A security measures has been taken. He has given the card number, that is the first step, and then the CVV number, which is there, which is a we can call it as almost a private key. He has given the CVV number, and with that they have entered into his account details. Again, the certifying authority has sent an OTP to his authorized mobile number. Whether he is aware of that particular transaction, that OTP also he has given to some other person. Okay, he should have known that fact. Okay, ignorance of law is not an excuse. Okay, so many times they will be giving the information that the OTP, nobody, no bank officials will ask for the OTP. Okay, that is your private key. Okay, that is your totally private key, that is for your use only, for confirmation. Okay, everybody and all the informations they will be giving, they will give the printed information, they will be telling in the phone, they will be displaying it on the notice board, all these things will be done. Okay, then also he has given the OTP number, then the amount has been withdrawn. This is a proper, this is a very good example of the cyber crime or the misuse of the private key, my dear friends. Okay, private key. So he should have a control over the private key. A person should have a control over the private key. Okay, under section 42 of Information Technology Act, if the private key of the corresponding public key is compromised, compromise means if he has given, somebody has misused, immediately that has to be intimated. Okay, immediately that has to be intimated to an authority, to a certifying authority or whatever may be the authority which is there, which is responsible for the issue of this particular digital signature certificates. Okay, it has to be communicated in a specified manner. It has to be in a specified manner, it has to be communicated, and see that you have to ensure that that has been done. Okay, the blocking of that card or blocking of digital signature certificate is done. Okay, the up to that point, that is the responsibility of the subscriber under section 42 of Information Technology Act. That is the control of private key, my dear friends. Okay, that is the section 42. So with this, before concluding, the few things will come to your mind. What do you mean by digital signature certificate? As I have told, digital signature certificate is like your physical signature certificate. Physical signature certificate may be your Aadhaar card, PAN card, or whatever may be. You have to show it to a particular authority whenever it is asked. Similarly, a digital signature certificate is one. You will give the your identity to a particular person wherever it is required digitally. Okay, so what is the process of obtaining DSC? The process of obtaining the DSC is you have to approach a certifying authority to get your digital signature certificates. Why DSC is required? To do electronic transactions. If you want to do add electronic transactions, you have to have a digital signature certificates. Who issues the, again, the certifying authorities will issue. Under the certifying authority which has been established under the controller of digital signatures, or under the control of Ministry of Corporate Affairs. Okay, Ministry of Corporate Affairs, they will issue the digital signature certificates. What are the different types of, what are all the different types of digital signature certificates? There are, we can call it as two types, my dear friends. One type we can call it as, it will be, first type is with the certificates, whatever you will give, they will issue the digital signature certificates based on the certificates you will give. For example, know your customer, KYC requirements. If you give that, a digital signature certificate will be given. EKYC you can give, electronic KYC certificates you can give. Then you will get the digital signature certificate. That is one thing. Or in some other things, you have to physically go. You have to give your thumb impression. You have to give your iris recognition, face recognition. Everything you have to give to get your digital signature certificates. That is the two types we can tell of having the digital signature certificate. What is the cost of obtaining the digital signature certificate? That depends. Okay, up to 25,000, that depends what type of certificate it is required. Okay, it will not exceed up to 25K according to the provisions in the Act. How much time does a CA take to issue the digital signature certificate? Is there any provisions? Yes, it is clearly mentioned. He has to take 6 to 7 working days. Okay, within that time, a digital signature certificate will be issued. Okay, if there is a clarification, if you have not provided the information properly, then it will take some more time. So what is the validity of the digital signature certificate? That also depends. Okay, that also depends. Some validity period will be fixed, 1 year, 2 year or 5 years or whatever may be, depending on the different conditions. For example, if you want to have a credit card, the validity will be mentioned. Debit card or credit card, from where to where it is mentioned. Depending on the type of certificate that you are applying, the validity will be mentioned. It is 1 year, 2 year or whatever may be. What is the legal status of DSC? Legally, it is secure. The IT Act 2000 will give all the legal recognition to the digital signature certificate. Okay, in a required places, as like your physical certificate, you can use your digital signature certificate. Okay, system requirement for the usage of DSC is minimum requirement of a desktop. Okay, desktop requirements with a proper Windows installed on that. That is the system requirement for the usage of digital signature certificates. Okay, these are all the important points that you have to note as an examination of point of view or with respect to general knowledge. These few points that is listed in the last slide is very much important, which will give a clear gist of what is the digital signature certificate, how to get it, how to get the digital signature certificate legally with respect to the Information Technology Act 2000. Okay, with this, my dear friends, let us conclude the today's session. Again, the reference is your prescribed textbook and the Bayer Act of Information Technology. Any law related, you have to go and access the Bayer Act, which is published by the government. Okay, where it will give the clear information. Okay, based on that only, the authors will explain further. Based on that Bayer Act only, they will explain further by giving certain examples. Whenever you want to explain the law with respect to the examination, my dear friends, that what is given in the Bayer Act is sufficient. If you want to understand or if you want to go in depth, you have to go further, you have to refer further books, you have to refer different authors so that you will get a clear information with examples. With this, we will conclude today's session. Okay. Thank you, everybody.